हेलो बॉयज, वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू इन ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ फिशरीज साइंस बीएससी सेकंड ईयर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ सेमिस्टर फोर्थ पेपर नंबर 9th फिश गियर एंड क्राफ्ट टेक्नोलॉजी। इन दिस पेपर 9th वी हैव सी द मटेरियल्स यूज्ड इन मैन्युफैक्चर ऑफ फिशिंग गियर्स Up to here, we have discussed detail about the different materials which is to be used, these are to be construct the nets. In these materials, varieties of fibers, that may be natural fibers, that may be synthetic fibers, or that may be man-made fibers. We have seen in last part, that is ropes, different ropes, these are to be manufactured, and these are to be useful for construction of netting as well as it is to be useful for the vessels or shipping. These ropes are of different four types we have studied, that is vegetable fiber ropes, second that is vegetable fiber ropes is the first ropes, second is the fiber ropes manufactured by fibers, third is the metal wire ropes, and fourth is the combination of fiber, combination of vegetable and combination of wire, that is the combination rope. Means these four types of ropes, these are to be you have seen last period during last part. Then how these ropes, these are to be identified? By using burning, by using identification of different aspects, by using these ropes, these are to be either it is to be monostrand or either it is to be multi-strand, four strand, means depending upon these strands, monofilament or that is a different part, these are to be formed. In these, which are the material, synthetic material, fiber material or the vegetable fibers or vegetable ropes, these are to be used in different countries, in different states or different areas. Now in today's part, materials used in manufacture of fishing gear, and in this materials used in manufacture of fishing gear, we have studied that is classification of ropes. How these ropes, these are to be classified, according to which criteria, according to which basis these ropes, these are to be classified, these ropes, these are to be categorized, these are to be seen today in this part, in this article. Yes. Classification of ropes based on the material used and their structure. These classification of ropes, these are to be studied, the ropes are broadly classified. As fiber ropes, metal wire ropes and combination ropes. The fiber ropes are further sub classified as vegetable fiber ropes. Example, those made from coir, manila, sisal, hemp, cotton, etc. And synthetic fiber ropes made from polyamide, PES, PP, PE, PVA and PVC. Mean these classification of ropes, these are to be classified either fiber ropes, either metal wire ropes and either combination ropes. Fiber ropes are further sub classified as vegetable fiber ropes. Those are to be produced from sisal, manila, hemp, coir, cotton. These are called as the fiber ropes. And synthetic ropes, which is to be made up of synthetic material such as polyamide, polyester, polypropylene, polyethylene, PVA and polyvinyl chloride. All these are the synthetic fiber. With these fibers, that is ropes are to be classified, ropes are to be prepared. Basic structure. Based on their structure, which is to be manufactured, laid and braided by these fibers or these ropes, the former ropes are classified as hawser laid ropes, then ensured laid ropes and cable laid ropes. These are the different ropes. Means first that is lead ropes. How these lead ropes, these are to be formed? Lead rope, these are to be classified as hawser rope or hawser lead ropes. Second, short lead ropes, and third, cable lead ropes. Means lead ropes are hawser lead ropes, short lead ropes, and cable lead ropes. Whereas braided ropes, these are to be again lateralized braided ropes. Lead ropes, these are formed by twisting the strands, resulting in helical formulation. These lead ropes, these are to be manufactured, these are to be fibrated. Lead ropes, these are to be fibrated, they can be formed by the twisting the strands, resulting in helical formulation. Hawser lead ropes is a formed three-strand rope. Hawser lead rope is a three-strand rope with the strands in helical formation. Means that is lead rope, these are to be formed twisting strands, resulting in helical formation. Hawser lead rope is the three-strand rope with strands in helical formation. And four-stranded lead ropes with the strands in helical formation is called as short lead rope. Means a four-strand rope is called as, that is a short ropes or the short. Means basic structure, based on their structure, either lead or it is to be braided. Lead ropes, hawser lead ropes, and that is the short four-stranded lead rope. These are the basic structure of these ropes which is to be formed, which is to be developed. A four-stranded lead rope with the strands in helical formation. A four-strand lead rope with strands in helical formation is called as short lead rope. In cable lead rope, the strand consists of ropes cabled together. In cable lead rope, the strands consist of ropes cabled together in the opposite direction to the lay of the constituent ropes. That is called as the cable lead rope. Cable lead rope, the strand consists of ropes cabled together in the opposite direction to the lay of the constituent ropes. Braided ropes, these braided ropes, they are formed by braiding where the strands are interlatched. Braided ropes, they are to be formed by braiding where the strands are interlaced in such a way that they cross each other in a diagonal pattern. In a braided ropes, these strands or these fibers, these are to be interlaced, these are to be interweaving to each other. Interweaving is to be done in such a way that they are cross each other in a diagonal pattern, in a diagonal manner, and forms the braided ropes. Means a four-stranded lead ropes, a cable lead ropes, and braided ropes, these are to form. The next, tubular braided ropes have been distinct advantages. Tubular braided ropes have distinct advantages since they are more pliable, dry faster, and are casier to handle. These are to be easier to handle. Means these braided ropes, they are formed by braiding where the strands are interlaced in such a way that they cross each other in a diagonal pattern. These tubular braided ropes have distinct advantages since they are more pliable, dry faster, and are easier to handle. Means these tubular braided ropes have a distinct advantages as compared to braided ropes, as compared to cable lead ropes, or as compared to, that is, the helical formation stroud lead ropes. These tubular ropes, braided ropes, have distinct advantages since they are more pliable, dry faster, and easier to handle. Their main drawbacks are difficulty in splitting and higher price. Their difficulty is to be splicing. These are to be difficult to splice from one part to another part, and their price is to be high. That's why these tubular braided ropes, those have to be a expenditure amount these person they can be purchased, they can be used for manufacturing or fabrication of the ropes. With these different ropes, these are to be formed, these are to be developed. See in this figure movable rampari net, these are to be used, and in this movable rampari net we can observe that here foot rope, then head rope stands. These foot ropes, head ropes, these are to present, and these foot rope and head rope, these are to be prepared, these are to be fabricated by different fiber ropes. These are to be fabricated by different ropes. That is because foot rope, these are to be specially indicating that those are the floats, as well as those are the sinker, these are to be attached to these both ropes, foot rope and head rope. Specially in head rope, that is float, these are to be attached. That float, these are to be buoyant on the water surface, and to the foot rope, sinkers, weight, these are to be attached. And as compared to the foot rope, head rope, these are to be small. Head rope, these are to be small and less weight, but size is to be larger. But foot rope is to be again large, it is to be strong, because maximum weight, sinker, these are to be attached to these foot ropes, and maximum load is to be dependable on the foot ropes. Hence this foot rope, these are to be strong as compared to the head rope, and these foot rope and head rope, these are to be access to attaching and to hold complete net intact manner. But as compared to the head rope, foot rope is to be strong, and these foot rope, these are to be in contact with rock, in contact with mud and other different disturbances. That is why these foot rope, these are to be durable, these are to be strong, and material which is to be used abundantly, wire and synthetic fiber material, as well as the, that is steel wire or metal wire, these are to be used to manufacture the foot rope. Metal wire, these are to be manufactured the foot rope. Due to these foot rope, that is metal wires, these are to be taken in erodent condition, then it is to be rotting resistance, it is to be easily pulled out, then towing resistance. That's why these are to be constructed, fabricated in the fabrication of net. Hope you have understood all these classification of ropes. Here we have completed different types of ropes, their classification, and how these ropes, these are to be identified. Hope you have understood all these parts. We have better way. Simply, there is a question is to be asked, arise, describe different types of ropes used in fabrication or manufacturing of fishing gear. At that time, we can write this article, that is the classification and that is manufacturing of ropes. These ropes, these are to be used for the material construction, for the net construction. Hope you have understood. In next part, we have seen the next article of our materials used in manufacturing of fishing gear. Thank you, all of you.